me to go and save him. Ya Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permitted me, and here I come to save you. So here you see somebody in trouble that raises his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers the prayer, as it says in the Quran, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرِّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ. Who answers the prayer of those that in need if they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And here, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرِّ, who answers this person who is in trouble? And the scholars here tell us, anybody, it's whether you are a believer or not a believer, if you put your hand and ask Allah, He will answer you. And the best example I always, and I travel a lot in a plane, so you see in the plane is going steady and everybody's eating, drinking, everybody's merry, talking, watching the movie, whatever. And then the plane goes through turbulence and it goes a little harder. And all this, people stop eating, the noise stops, the talking stops, and everybody's quiet. And you know everybody's praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're praying to God, whether they are atheists, non-believers or whatever, they are praying. It reminds me of a show I was watching about a plane in trouble, and the lady was described the same scene. She said everybody became quiet, and I know they were praying. أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرِّ, who answers the prayers of those that are troubled if they ask. So regardless whether they believe in Allah or not, if they are in trouble, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us an example which always says a ship in the water, and then the waves have gone high, and the winds are strong winds and high waves. And again, the same example, everybody stops and raises their hand to Allah and say, save us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I save you. And then when you go back to the safety of the land, you go back to your deeds and you forget there is a God, and. And this is the story of most of us. You know, when we're in trouble, in our heart we know there is God and we raise our hand, and when we go back and we feel safe, we forget. So maybe, inshallah, we ask Allah that we never forget, we stay on the straight path, and we always pray for Allah and ask Allah to accept our prayers. There's a lot more to come. Please stand by. We'll talk after the break, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum and welcome back to Muslim Chronicle. Today, inshallah, we are talking about dua, prayers, raising your hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking Him. And in Surah Al-Baqarah, the chapter of Al-Baqarah in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبُ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ. If we reflect on the meaning of this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying Prophet Muhammad and telling us all after this, if my servants ask about me, tell them I am close, I answer the prayers of those who ask. So two things, tell them I'm close, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is close to us all the time and answers our prayers. And this is very important. Actually, in the Quran, there's a lot of places where it says to Prophet Muhammad, they ask you about something and the answer comes back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Prophet Muhammad, tell them. They ask about the crescent, tell them the crescent is for times and for people learning about time and dates. They ask a lot of things in the Quran and the answer comes back, tell them. Except in this ayah where it says, when they ask about Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am close to them. I will tell them. I will answer back. Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us all the time, asking us to pray and to ask Him, and we should never give up on the answer. We know it will happen. Some scholars tell us, you never give up, it will happen. And you will get it, because as we said in the other verse, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ, your God has said, ask me and I will answer. So the prayers will always be answered. Sometimes it takes a little longer time because it's better for you. And sometimes it happens to us, but we don't realize because we're busy with our life. I'd like, you know, some of the things or some of the times or the people that their prayers are answered, the person who is fasting. So if you're fasting, whether in the months of Ramadan or fasting outside, if you're fasting, your prayers is answered. The traveling, a person who's traveling while they're traveling, because, you know, they're away from their home, they're away from their family, away from everything, they're close to Allah and Allah is with them, and their prayers are answered. Al-Mazloom, somebody who injustice have happened to them. Those who are injustice happens to them, their prayers are answered. And that's why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, be aware, don't inflict injustice on anybody, regardless whether they're good or bad. If they're good or bad, this person, that's on them. But their prayers will be answered. So you never inflict injustice on anybody. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the prayer that when somebody whose injustice happened to them, I will fulfill your prayer even after a while, but it will be fulfilled. Another person that their prayers are answered is Imam Adil, a just governor, a just ruler. Because sometimes it's very hard when you're in a position of power to be just. And it takes a lot of effort and a lot of work. And these people, their prayers are answered. Let's go and share a couple of stories about answered prayers. They say that, as we know in Islam, when somebody passes away, we wash them before, and then we cover them in white before we bury them. And usually it's a lady who is washing a lady. So this lady in Al-Madinah died, and this lady came to wash her, preparing her for burial. And this lady that died had bad reputation. So the lady that was washing her looked at her body and said in her mind, oh, this body disobeyed Allah a lot of times. You had a beautiful body and it disobeyed Allah a lot of times. And while she was wiping the body, her hand stuck to the dead woman's body. They try everything to unstuck the hand, they couldn't. They go to the scholars, what do we do? The lady's hand isn't stuck to the body of the dead lady. Some of them said, well, the live lady is more important, cut the skin of the lady that's dead. Some said, no, we have to respect the dead, cut the hand of the woman. Total chaos, what do they do? So they went to Imam Malik radiallahu anhu, which is one of the great scholars of that time, and asked him, what do we do? So he asked them one question, before I tell you my ruling, go and ask this lady, what were you thinking about when this happened? So she had to say the truth. She said, I was thinking this woman committed a lot of sins with her body. So Imam Malik's ruling was, whip this lady 80 times because she accused the dead lady of something she is not sure of. And in Islam, you cannot just accuse people or throw accusation as people. So she accused this lady with her thoughts in her mind that she committed all these bad deeds. So they brought some ladies and whipped this lady 80 times. And after the 80 whip, her hand released. And this lady, she tells us she went to sleep, and in her dream, she dreamt of the dead lady, and the dead lady told her, yes, I used to sin a lot, but one time while I was sinning, I was going to get caught, and I prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, protect me, Ya Allah, cover up for me, and I'll never sin again, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted my prayer and covered up for me, and then I died after this. So here, yes, she used to sin, but the moment she died, she had asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for her to forgive her, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven her. And this lady, when she in her mind accused her of these bad things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had forgiven her. So here, it's very important. We realize the prayer is answered.